you tell them one thing. Just win, baby.
It's your boy Samori, the back at it again with another video. And just yesterday, the Raiders uploaded a video on their YouTube channel of their supposed mock draft done by an NFL draft analyst called Chad Reuter. I don't know who the hell that is, but I'm going to go over all the picks that he projected the Raiders to have in 2021 and give you guys my thoughts on it. And also, you guys can look at this draft and also rate it for yourself whether you think it's a good draft or a bad mock draft. You could even give it a grade. I think it was kind of alright, but you know what? That's just me. So as of right now, you guys know that the Raiders have 8 draft picks in this year's draft. Now, I don't think the Raiders need 8 players, 8 new rookies. So I feel like the Raiders could move up or move back depending on how this draft is going to be. And it's going to be kind of crazy on draft day, but when that time comes, we'll talk more about it. But as of right now, I'm just going to go over all the picks that he picked for the Raiders in this 2021 NFL mock draft. And let's start off with the 17th overall pick. He had the Raiders selecting Jamin Davis, linebacker out of Kentucky. Now, I'm like, whoa. Jamin Davis is a good linebacker, but in the first round, I think it's a bit of a reach. But knowing the Raiders, we're used to doing that. You know, we're used to reaching for a player that we don't even expect to go that high. You know, look at Cleveland Farrell. We didn't expect him to be the number 4 overall pick, but we did want him later on in the draft. Not only that, last season, nobody even thought of us getting Damon Arnett in the first round, but the Raiders really liked him that much to go out and get him. Now, I feel like this is a questionable move for the Raiders if we were to select Jamin Davis. I do like him as a prospect, as a linebacker, and I feel like he does have a high ceiling, so much potential as a player, especially on the defensive side. I know that his draft stock is rising as of right now, but the only downside I see in Jamin Davis, honestly, is that he only had 1 year to show that he was a starter. He's on the smaller side as a linebacker, so he's gonna have to bulk up in the NFL, but he is a versatile linebacker. He could play, you know, the Mike, the Will, the Sam, wherever you want him on the defensive side, especially under Gus Bradley's system. I think that he does have a lot of potential.
Like I said before, I'll play anything you want me to play. So, I mean, as far as being versatile with Mike, Will, outside backer, anything. Like I said, I'll play center if you wanted me to.
He has a speed. He's a solid tackler. He's good in coverage and has a lot of range. And he is good in short area quickness. I'm not even going to lie. Jamin Davis had a solid pro day, having a 4.41 40 speed, 11-foot broad jump, and a 42-inch vertical leap. Now, I do understand why the Raiders would be interested in a guy like Jamin Davis. But for me, I think this is just a little bit too early for him, even though I know that his draft stock is rising and this guy can, you know, be versatile on the defensive side, as especially as a linebacker, a guy that's good in coverage. You know, we need that type of linebacker on our defense. But if we're going for a linebacker in the first round, honestly, for me, the only 3 linebackers I think is, you know, worth that first round pick would be Jock, would be Micah Parsons, and maybe Zaven Collins. He's one of my favorite linebackers in this draft as well. But to get a guy like Jamin Davis, who I think is projected, you know, in the second round, maybe early third round, to get him in the first round, I think is a bit of a reach for me. But Raider Nation, what do you think about this pick so far? Jamin Davis out of Kentucky in the first round with the 17th overall pick. Now we're moving on to the second round with the 48th selection in the NFL draft. He has us selecting Javon Holland, free safety out of Oregon. Now, I know the Raider Nation is 50-50 on Javon Holland. Me, I'm not on either side. I'm a guy that's really optimistic, and I feel like he has a lot of potential. Now, I know I was on a live show not too long ago with Graf, you know, with everybody on there, and I know some of the boys on there don't really like Javon Holland, and I'm not going to knock Javon Holland. I feel like Javon Holland does have some untapped potential. I mean, he does have a high floor, and he could play that single high safety and also play in the slot, and I feel like if the Raiders were to draft him and bring him to the team, I think he could start as that slot corner. Now, I know that he opted out of the 2020 season, so we didn't really get to see him. The last time we did see him was in the 2019 season. But Holland is a playmaker. All he does is make plays. In his 2 seasons in college, he has 9 interceptions and 11 pass breakups. Holland has that size and length that you look for in the secondary. Not only that, he has a lot of range and he has fluid hips, which again, you could use that a lot in the secondary. As far as ball skills, he has it. He knows where the ball is at all times, no matter if he's in a slot or at the free safety position. And when you're talking about a versatile player, Javon Holland is that. Now, I do believe if we were to draft Javon Holland in the second round or maybe the third round if he falls, which I kind of doubt, but if we were to draft him, I feel like he could step in and be our day one slot cornerback on this team. Now, I wouldn't put him at the free safety position, but I do believe that he's versatile enough to play a couple of snaps at the free safety position. Now, again, these are just projections. He does have a lot of potential, but again, he's got to show it on the next level. I don't know why he's getting a lot of hate, to be honest. I mean, looking at his films and whatnot, he does look like a solid talent. Now, honestly, for me, I wouldn't be mad if the Raiders went out and got Javon Holland. Now, I know other guys would be mad, but I do feel like there's other players out there that the Raiders could actually go get in the second round, someone like a Richie Grant. If you're looking for a versatile player that could play, you know, single high safety and in the slot, you're looking at a guy like Elijah Molden from Washington. That's one of my favorite prospects in the second round if we were to go in that direction. But getting Javon Holland, I'm okay on it. This guy has a lot of potential, like I said before. And if we're talking speed, he ran a 4.46, which I think is solid for a cornerback of his size. Again, Raider Nation, what do you guys think about getting Javon Holland in the second round with the 48th selection? Let me know down in the comments below. Now, moving over to the third round with the 79th overall selection, Chad had the Raiders going out and selecting Paulson Adebo, cornerback out of Stanford. Now, this is another addition to the secondary, which I think is necessary for the team. But to be honest with you guys, I did not know too much about Adebo before this video, so I had to do some homework. I had to look at some tape, and I think that he's a solid player. Now, I'm not going to say that he's an all-pro or he's going to be a day one starter, but I feel like he does add depth to the secondary. Honestly, I think this was a bit of a reach as well. I think there's other options out there that we could address other than getting another cornerback at this position. But again, Adebo is a solid player that has athleticism and has length. On top of that, he has good ball skills and has fluid hips. And in his two seasons, he's had 8 interceptions, 24 pass breakups. And he's a cornerback that can only play on the outside, so I wouldn't play him at any snaps on the inside as a slot corner. Now, even with all the upside that he has coming into the NFL, he does struggle a lot with tackling in the open field. On top of that, he gives up big plays off of double moves. And in 2020, he opted out of the season, so we didn't get to see him play in 2020. The last time we seen him was in 2019. Yet, this is another player that opted out of the season, which I'm just like, okay, hopefully these guys can come into the league and pick up where they left off. Now, going into the 2020 season before he opted out, he was considered a first-round talent, maybe a early day two player, but you know, after not playing in the 2020 season, he falls down to like the third, maybe fourth round, somewhere in the mid rounds. But if we were to add him to the team, he would just be more of a depth chart piece on our team. I don't know what to think about this move. I feel like there's other players that I would rather go get in the third round, but this is a guy that I feel like addresses a need in our defense. So Raider Nation, what do you guys think about this pick with the 79th overall pick selecting Paulson Adebo? Do you think it's a good move, or do you think we could go out and get a better player at this position? Let me know down in the comments below. As you guys already know, we have 2 third round picks. So we have the 79th and the 80th overall pick in this year's draft. And with the 80th overall pick, they went out and selected an offensive tackle, Brady Christensen, out of BYU. Man, I do like this pick, man. Getting Brady Christensen in the third round, 6'6", 300 pounds. And this draft, if you think about it, is filled with so many great talent at the offensive tackle position. You know, you could get one in the first, second, or third round. And I feel like if we don't address a tackle in our first or second round, this would be the way to go in the third round. And there's so many great talent here. Like a guy like Brady Christensen and any other draft would be a first round, early second round pick. So getting him in a third round, I think would be a solid move for the Raiders. Honestly, this would be one of my favorite moves in this mock draft because we're getting a guy, you know, a position of need at the right draft position. You know, this is a guy that is ranked somewhere around the third round or maybe fourth round at the latest. But getting him here in the third round would be an absolute steal for this team. Christensen is responsible for keeping Zach Wilson clean throughout the whole 2020 season. And even though he plays left tackle right now, I'm sure that the Raiders would move him to the right side. Christensen does have great upper body strength and good football IQ. Now, he's not the most athletic tackle coming into the NFL. I do think that he would struggle against some of the more athletic pass rushers in the league if he was to stay at that left tackle position. But good thing for the Raiders, he would most likely move over to the right side as our right tackle. He can also play that right guard position if we needed him to and move Denzel Good to that right tackle position. Either way, we're getting a solid offensive lineman here in the third round. So what do you guys think, Raider Nation, about this move? Do you guys think it's a good move for the Raiders, or would you guys rather get a tackle earlier, someone like a Tevin Jenkins or Jalen Mayfield? Again, let me know down in the comments below, and also grade this move for the Raiders. And last but not least, with the 121st overall pick in the fourth round, they doubled up and got another offensive lineman, getting Aaron Banks guard out of Notre Dame. This is another behemoth of a man on the offensive line, 6'6", 330 pounds. Again, this is another solid move to help bolster up our offensive line. Banks does have experience, you know, being a multi-year starter at Notre Dame. And if you guys know Notre Dame, they have some of the best offensive linemen ever, you know, going into the draft. Banks has a wide base and has great hands. And he's also good in pass protection. Now, he's not the quickest by any mean, and he has no athleticism, but he would be a solid guard in the NFL. Now, I believe that he could take over Incognito's role in the future when he decides to hang his boots up. But I do think that he would just be a depth chart piece right now. He would be a backup until his time is called up. Now, he does remind me a lot of Gabe Jackson, you know, a mid-round talent that could step in and be a solid pass protector on the offensive line. So I believe if he's coached up right, he would flourish in our offensive line, especially with Tom Capel as our coach. I think Aaron Banks would be solid, you know, for the future. So this is another solid move for the Raiders, getting Aaron Banks in the fourth round. Again, great this move. What do you think about it down in the comments below? Now, with the remaining picks that we do have, the last three picks of our draft, with those two fifth round picks and that one sixth round pick, he didn't really go into mocking any specific players at those positions, but he did think that the Raiders would address running back and defensive line with those last three picks. So as of right now, I'm just going to give you guys three running backs and three defensive linemen that we could actually address or even look at in those three last picks. So these are some of my favorite players, starting off with the three running backs I wouldn't mind getting at the end of the draft. The first running back would be Ramondre Stevenson out of Oklahoma State. This is a big thumper of a running back. We already have Josh Jacobs, who's a thumper and can catch the ball. We have Kenyon Drake, who's, you know, the best of both worlds, can catch the ball and can run the ball as well. So I feel like we do need that thumper that we could bring in to help take the load off of Josh Jacobs. And I feel like Ramondre Stevenson would be that guy. He reminds me so much of Michael Bush. And if you guys remember Michael Bush, that dude was a baller, you know, and he was great, you know, taking the load off of Darren McFadden back in the day. So Ramondre Stevenson in the late rounds, I feel like we should target him. The other two players is Javion Hawkins and Trey Sermon, two potential running backs that could fall in the late rounds that we could pick up that could provide some solid depth at our running back position. Now, moving on to some defensive linemen, three names off the boards that I really do like in the later rounds would be Charles Snowden, a defensive end out of Virginia. Marlon Tuipulotu, defensive tackle out of USC. I mean, he's a solid depth piece and would be a solid run defender on our defensive line, you know, a rotational defensive tackle for this defense. And another guy that could do the same thing as well is Kyrus Tonga, defensive tackle out of BYU. So these are three players that I do like on the defensive line if we were to address it at the end of the draft. All right, Raider Nation, that is all I have for you guys on this video. Let me know what you guys think about this mock draft that the Raiders posted on their YouTube channel just yesterday. What grade would you guys give it? If you were to ask me, I honestly think that he reached on a couple of players, you know, in those first couple of rounds. So I would give it somewhere around a C plus. And I'm just being honest, you know, maybe a B minus if I'm just trying to be nice. But let me know what you guys think down in the comments below. If you guys enjoyed the video, don't forget to smash that like button. And with all that being said, Raider Nation, this your boy Samoa Raider, and your boy is, yeah.